Woohoo! Hello and welcome. Oh, yay. Okay, so hopefully this is working. And okay, Disha, hi. Hi, hi, hi. Okay, the lighting is a little bit intense. I don't know if I can change that. Okay, so today I'm working with a Yeti microphone and a webcam that is higher quality. So hopefully this looks good. Let me know if it does. Let me change this to live chat. So if somebody could share on our Telegram that we are here, that would be great. Yay! Okay, so today we're going to be playing some Christmas songs. Go ahead and grab the printable. It's not a printable, actually. Open up the link that I put in the description box. It should take you to Last Christmas. Ukulele is so frustrating. I'm practicing. It's okay. It's okay. It takes a little bit of time. Okay. I'm testing out the microphone. Were you able to hear me? Like, I think I tried muting. Okay, so on the link down below, you have... Hi, I'm Alicia. Hello. You have the option to play in the key, meaning that whatever you see there is what you play. So, you got a D, B minor, then E minor, and then A. Now, let's say that you don't like those chords or you can't play those chords. Then if you're on a computer, you see the option to transpose at the very bottom of your screen. You can transpose, and I would do minus two. And that would give you the chords. Hi, Shelly. Hi, Sayara. C, A minor, D minor, then G. Hi, Ellie. Madeline. Hi. Hi, Nigel. Last Christmas. Let me see. To find the singing note. What is the singing note there? Let me see. Sometimes when I don't know what a singing note is, I just pull out the tuner. Oh, it's on a D.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, give it to someone special.
So, I linked the song that we're playing today. Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate that you're making time to hang out with me here today. I added a link down below for the song that we're playing today, and this is on the Ultimate Guitar website. However, the Ultimate Guitar website has gotten smart, and they added the chord charts for ukulele and for piano. The great thing is that if you always wanted to learn how to play piano, all you have to do is tap on the piano tab, piano option, and it tells you where to put your fingers. The same that you would do for a chord here on the ukulele, you can do the same thing on a piano. So if you have a piano and you want to start playing some of these songs, you know, just start by doing the quarter notes. Da, 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 like this.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart.
And just start slowly. Okay. So go to the ukulele tab. And what I did is I hit the transpose minus two so that everything is in the key of C. That's C, A minor, D minor, and G. By the way, there are 54 people here. Would you all please hit the like button? This helps the video perform so much better on YouTube, and that helps the channel continue growing. Not that we need more people. I love that you're here, and the fact that you are here is all we need. I want to give a big, big, big shout out to all of the people who are part of the Uklandia magazine staff. We have released our new Uklandia magazine issue. So if you go to uklandiamagazine.com, Stefan, who's here, has worked really hard on the website to make it look great and make it work. And the entire staff have worked really hard on articles and design and cartoons and pictures and interviews so that the magazine is lovely for you to read. And is anyone here from India? Yeah, there are a bunch of people here from India, I'm pretty sure. Hi, Nigel. Hi, Manchika. Hi, Sean. Hi, Peg. How is the Yuku compared to the Enya? Do you want an honest review? A brutally honest review? I don't do brutally honest reviews on the channel because then people who are fans of either brand come to the comment section and harass me or harass other people. So instead, I keep the reviews very light. But I think in a live stream, I can give brutally honest reviews because usually fans of a brand aren't like watching my live streams. Usually it's the Uke fam who's like really into the channel. And thank you for those likes. And there's more people here. Hi. We got the Netherlands here. Actually, can you let me know which city and prefecture state you're watching from and our country? So I'm in, technically, politically, it's called El Centro, but it's really a little tiny, teeny, tiny town called Sili. Let me see what the population is where I'm at. It's tiny. And I'm saying politically, it's called El Centro population because I think that somebody kind of wealthy owned the house that I live in. I'm not saying that I'm this wealthy person, but whoever built this house owned, I don't know how many acres, hundreds of acres of property and like cow farms and hay bales and fields and crops and machinery and the warehouses, everything. And so I think for some reason they zoned this as El Centro, which is like the bigger city in where I live. But I'm like 11 miles from El Centro and I'm 1 mile from Sili, California. The population is 2,000 people. So that's where I'm living. So let me know where you're living. Another one from the Netherlands. Yay! It's my dream to go to the Netherlands. Like my dream. You know, I heard today that like a wish without action is just a dream. So if you have a dream, you should take action to make it happen. So I'm gonna set a date on when I will go to the Netherlands. Den Haag, Holland, Wisconsin. I'm persevering with the Donner. I think I have been spoiled with the Uma. Yes, Uma, I think is like, honestly, Uma is a top brand in my eyes. I think where they failed is the marketing, because their youths are like really great and really beautiful. Angie, I don't know if you're here. Yeah, Angie, you have your Uma, right? I think the only thing that failed Uma is their marketing. They did not put as much energy behind their marketing as brands like Enya did. And I think that's it. Like, had they really promoted their product, I think they would be a household name. Like, I think everybody would have an Uma like they have an Enya nowadays. And I'm not saying everybody has an Enya, but it seems like 9 out of 10. Yes to the brutal reviews. Hi, Georgiana. Have you received your ukulele yet, by the way? Or do you know when they're going to send it? I was born in Vernon, South Florida, Mobile, Alabama, USA. Oh, my goodness. Mobile, Alabama has my favorite. Okay, so one of the things that I liked doing when I was younger, when like in college, is to watch really ridiculous news anchor bloopers. Like, if you want to have a good laugh, like a crying laugh, watch news anchor bloopers because they're live and they can't control what happens, you know, on a live stream around people. And there's just so many funny videos. And one of my all-time favorite ones was a video from Mobile, Alabama, where people were gathered around this tree because they swore they saw a leprechaun. You know, like that little, like Irish, what is it called? Like a duende. I don't know how you say duende in English, but the people are saying, I seen a leprechaun. And like, it just, look up leprechaun in Mobile, Alabama, and you will laugh and cry. India, aloha, Albuquerque. Aloha, Ukulele Project Hawaii is here. Hey, South Florida, Portland, Oregon. Oh, no way, Portland, Ontario, Canada, Denver, Colorado, Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. Barbara N is here. Yes, magazine staff, congrats in Germany. How do you highlight your name? So people that have a highlighted name are moderators. And I've chosen the moderators based on people who are just regular viewers of this channel and who like participate a lot. Actually, I'm adding a few right now. I haven't added moderators in a while. And moderators help to keep the chat friendly and safe because they have more controls over what's happening in the chat. Like they're able to mute people and block people and remove. And this is really helpful because I'm actually a sensitive person. And so when I see comments that are really aggressive, I get really hurt. So a gnome, thank you. Duende is a gnome, thank you. And so having several moderators helps me to not always see the hate comments. And if I see it, usually the moderators will see it and remove them. Created me, hey! So anyway, that's why I have moderators. Hey, Jennifer, how are you? Oh man, let's fill the chat with all of the colored hearts for Jennifer, who works super, super, super hard on the designing of the magazine. So amazing. I don't think that you've been recognized here on a live stream. Other people we've given emojis to and hearts to. So let's fill the chat with hearts for Jennifer. But you have thousands who love you. Yes, and I try to focus on thousands who love me, but sometimes, you know, when there's something, you know, we all have negative voices in our head sometimes, you know, sometimes you think bad things about yourself and you wouldn't say that out loud, right? Or you wouldn't even talk like that to somebody else, the way that sometimes we talk to ourselves. But when you have like an insecurity, you never tell anyone. And then when somebody sees it and writes a comment on that insecurity that you thought it was just a secret between you and you, those comments hurt. And so sometimes people really pinpoint those and it's really hurtful. So having moderators helps to not have so many people have access to just hurt me, you know, because that's what they're doing. They're just leaving hurt and negative things. And so thank you, moderators, for everything. Okay, so let's do a little bit of jamming. Give me a C. Give me an A minor. Leave your middle finger where it's at. Pivot the middle finger a little bit like a door hinge and make that ring finger fit behind it. And now drop the hand and make the index finger fit for a D minor. Send you a beso de queso. Thank you. And then a G. Okay, and according to the Ultimate Guitar website, you should do down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Asia! Down, down, up, down, up, down. And everything has 8 beats. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Switch. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. And 2, 2, and 3, and 4. And musicians are taught to count like that. So let me teach you how to count like a musician. When you have 2 bars, you will say 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and then the next bar you count as 2, 2, and 3, and 4, and so 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 2, 2, and 3, and 4, and dancers will count all the way up to 8, but musicians count to 4. And so a way to keep in mind how many bars you're counting is 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 2. If there were more bars, 3, 2, and 3, and 4, and 4, 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, 2, and 3, and 4, and so that's a way to count a lot of music with just like that. And no, I haven't done the brutal review. You haven't missed it. You haven't missed it. But let's jam a little bit because people are gonna say like she's just talking. We're not playing. Here we go. 1, 2, 1. Hi Sam. Ready, go. Down, 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 down. A minor. This is just the intro. D minor. Thank you, Sanjeev. Let's drop some pink hearts for the super chat. And the chorus.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. The very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special.
The next part.
Last Christmas, gave you my heart. But the very next day, gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, give it to someone special.
Interlude. A minor. D minor. G. And let's pause here because Shelley's bringing up a good point. So on this one, we're using the C, A minor, F, and G version, which is the easier version, but you can transpose it back up to D. And if you want to be able to play if the C version, but play with the recording, you can use your capo on the second fret. And that would make your C sound like a D. See how it's, I'm on the second fret and I'm playing a C chord. Listen to the sound real quick. Now let me remove that and play a D. Or like this. So that capo up two frets turns it into a D. Review. I'm kind of hiding it further into the live stream so that I don't get attacked by fans of the brand. I don't have an India elf right now. I have that one, but it doesn't, the Nova Pro doesn't match. Okay. Brutally honest review. Somebody asked for my opinions on the ukulele. I think the fairest thing would be to compare two ukuleles of equal price. So I think my signature ukulele would be the most fair comparison. I don't know if I have one handy though. I try to rotate the ukes I have out so that I'll play different ones. Okay, so brutally honest review of this ukulele. This ukulele is gorgeous. I love it. It's beautiful. It sounds great. My criticism, I guess, of ukuleles nowadays is that they all come with the super now gut Aquila strings. And it's like, why does everything come with these? Like, they're so tough to break in the beginning. So, but I don't want to be wasteful and remove these strings just yet because I don't want to be wasteful. But I would love to hear this ukulele with fluorocarbon strings. I have a thing where I don't like a lot of ukulele headstocks. I think a lot of ukulele headstocks are ugly. Like some of them are just square and plain. That's just my opinion. So I really love slotted headstocks because I think it makes them look beautiful. But this one I like because it's got a wave. It's different. It's unique. It's creative. It's not a boring block. The name Yuku to me sounds very like American, and I like how like the other Yuks like are like Lanikai, you know, that sounds very Hawaiian and I like that. Or like Leolani sounds Hawaiian, that's pretty cool. Ortega sounds so Spanish, I like that too, even though they're not Spanish. So like to me Yuku, I don't love it, this is the brutally honest review, but I do love what they did with their name where they added it in abalone, and I think that completely saved it. Now I don't usually see headstocks with wood grain like this, but this one has it and I love it. And then I don't know what type of tuners they used on this ukulele, but they're much smoother than the chrome, like the silver chrome tuners that you see on like 80% of ukuleles. These, when I turn them, it feels like they've been oiled and smoothed out. It's so nice. I think the wood grain on this uke, look at that. That almost looks like a lion. It's so beautiful. And I'm going to compare it to Enya right now, okay? Look at that. And the gloss is also really nice. I love abalone. Like, if you give me extra abalone, to me, it's like getting extra guac at Chipotle. I'm happy. And then the fret markers are also abalone. Like, they did not skimp out on the design of the ukulele, right? It's really beautiful. And I love spruce top. I've shared that before. Those of you who've been following me for like more than 2 years, you know I rave about a spruce top with warm sides, warm ukulele sides. I think when I replace the strings on this, it's going to be my favorite uke. And when they sent it to me, they wanted me to just show them off in a video. And I love that Yuku didn't say, give us a positive review or talk about how much you love it. They didn't say that. They just said, use them in a video. And I like when brands are like that, you know, they're risking, but I like that. I like that they were just like, give us a review. And they didn't say positive. So I just shared what I liked about the instrument. The bad thing about this is that you're paying over $200 and it does not come with gig bag. And this is where Enya has kind of spoiled us. It does not come with a gig bag. It does not come with extra strings or an accessories bag or a clip-on tuner. So it feels like, oh, I paid for $200 for an instrument and I don't get anything. It's just the instrument and like tissue paper, right? So that part is not great feeling, if you know what I mean, because Enya has spoiled us. Now, what I do like about this brand is that I know that in my purchase, I'm creating jobs for people in the States. It's not just jobs overseas. It's jobs here in the States. Like there are people here in Colorado and across the States who are working on these ukuleles. And I'm not saying they're assembled here, but who are working on the brand and distributing. And I like that. UKULELE also does a lot of charitable work. So like, let's say that I became a UKULELE artist. Instead of them paying me money, they would say, all right, choose a library, wherever you want, choose a library and we'll send them a class set of ukuleles for people to check out for free. Like they would check out a library book. And hi, I came from Mr. Gastelum's class. Hi. So to me, that's so awesome that they would do, and yes, this is the wolf. To me, it's so awesome that they would do that. You know, that their mission is to get ukuleles in every home. That's their mission statement. And that the trade-off of working together would be like, we're going to send ukuleles to a library of your choice. That to me is like a way better brand deal than getting paid. Not because I don't like money. I do love making money through my business. That part is like, of course, I love making money through my business. And that was something that hurt when I was a teacher in a classroom. That like when I got my first job teaching here in my area, I thought like, wow, I'm not getting compensated for the amount of school that I did and for the amount of hours I'm putting in. The action on this, I would say, is really great here in the first frets, but I know some of you wouldn't like the action on the higher frets. I don't mind it because I feel like the higher frets are so easy to press down. But I know some of you are really spoiled with your action, and I would say that it is higher than you would see on any ukuleles. But on the first frets, it's like really, 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 really low. Not to the point where it creates a buzz, but it's low. And the sound to me is really beautiful. They sent to me and they said, hey, you can play it and then put it on your shop. Consider that I have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 19, 20 ukuleles in my room. This is the one I haven't been able to put down. This one. I haven't been able to put down. And they said, put it in your shop. I don't think I'm going to be able to. I loved it. And so that's when I started thinking, like, okay, well, maybe, like, the great thing about Enya sending you all of the accessories means that you are missing a little bit on the higher quality of the instrument. Like, for Enya to be able to send a spalted ukulele with a spruce top with gears like this, I think, and all the accessories, it would hike up the price a lot more. So I think... now at this point, I don't care that they didn't send me geek bag and all of those extra things because I'm so happy with this ukulele. So I have a secret that I will share with you. So Ben is the guy that like is my contact, right? He's my contact and let me see. Okay, so here, he sent me the ukes and he asked me when I was going to publish the video. I said, dude, that wolf tenor is a dream. And he said, you love it? And I said, I am in love. And he said, I'm so excited about it. We only have 7 left. And I said, wow. And he said, gonna make some more for sure, but we won't be restocked till February. And then I said, spill the tea. I said, we need to make a signature uke together sometime. And he said, let's do it. Let's do it this month and release it in mid-February. We would be so excited too. And I said, you're kidding. I just got butterflies. And he said, I'm at dinner with my family, but let's talk Monday and get something going. And I said, okay, bon appetit. And then I sent him a long list. That's a long list of what I would like to see in an ideal signature ukulele. And he said, hey, Bernadette, we have our weekly marketing meeting this week, and I will definitely chat about this. Let's connect Friday. And I said, perfect. So that's where things are at. I cannot keep a secret from you all. But I would love to launch a signature uke with Yuku. Because what I've seen from Yuku were the tattoo ukuleles, you know, the ones that have the little design like Luna. And for me, like, those are great, but I want to see something amazing in a signature model, you know? Like, I felt like the signature that I did with Enya recently was really nice, you know, with the bougainvillea on the inlay, the the embroidered gig bag, the slotted headstock, the mahogany that was stained into a fuchsia color, the fluorocarbon strings. The sound was really, really sweet, you know? And that's a ukulele that I couldn't put down for a long time. And still now to this day, I think it's one of the best sounding ukes that Enya has made. I'm biased, but that's my opinion. And I've seen other companies that I really like, but there'd be like, I like this, but, or I like that, but, you know, it wasn't like, I love it. Like, this purple uke is everyone's favorite, or not everyone, but so many people like it, the Lanikai. But, and it is beautiful. It's more beautiful than my signature uke. But side by side, when I want to record something beautiful, I still go to my signature uke because it has that sweet sound. And so I hadn't seen a signature, I hadn't seen a ukulele that made me think, okay, yeah, it's time for another signature. So I thought I probably won't make another one until years from now. And then this one entered my life and I was like, oh my gosh. And seeing that Yuku can do something of this level to me was like, okay, now it's time. Now is the time. So it's one of those, you don't know it till you see it, you know? So knowing that they can do something of this level was really exciting for me. The signature uke that I'd be making with them, what the list that I sent them of things that I want to see are things that I haven't seen in a ukulele unless they've been custom made and it's like $4,000. And I don't want to make a signature uke with someone that costs $4,000 or $2,000 or even $1,000 or even $500. Like, I'm still very much at the, not necessarily budget uke, because I feel like a budget uke is like a $100 uke, but I want it to be something that you could afford, you know? And I guess affording something is a broad range, but not a $500 ukulele. So that's what I sent him, my wish list of what I would love to see in a uke. And hopefully it's something that you don't have in your collection if you decide to buy something for, buy one for yourself. A reminder is to never tell you a secret. Yeah, never tell me a secret. I can't. We keep secrets the same way. Bye, Lucia. So yeah, that's the update on the signature uke. And I love that UKULELE, this company, works so hard with charity and libraries to donate ukuleles. Like, I love that that's their mission. They're so, so, so cool. Okay, so today I wanted to teach Jingle Bell Rock. But let me see, did I pull it? Yeah, I did pull it up. Okay. Jingle Bell Rock. Okay. So I'll share the link with you right now. I'll share you the link. Who talks like that? I think te comparto. Maybe I was thinking in Spanish. Sometimes I say things that I'm thinking in Spanish. I just translate them and they don't sound right. So I'm sorry for that. If I ever sound a little off, it's my brain thinking in Spanish and translating. You know how sometimes things don't translate? Okay, this has a lot of chords. I just shared Jingle Bell Rock. When is the Christmas Fest with Abby? You know how we have our Wednesday lessons? Hi, Melinda. So this Wednesday we have a lesson, and then I believe next Wednesday. That's another thing I used to do as a kid when I was learning English, is I would say Wednesday to know how to spell it. I think Abby arrives on the 13th here. So in like 10 days, it'll be the Wednesday lesson. Reminder to self, don't buy a uke till February. Yeah, you don't buy a uke till February, because either you get the wolf or you get the burn. I don't know. I shouldn't call it that. I just cringed at myself. I don't know what to call it, but. And so far I have two signature ukuleles, right? One with Flight was what, which was the cherry blossom one, and the one with Anya, which was the bougainvillea. I like being inspired by plants and flowers, so I'll have to look for a flower that'll inspire this one. And Tammy is saying this is the guitar version. So it is on the guitar website. And you know where it says, like, Jingle Bell Rock by Bobby Helms, key of D, and then it says chords. You have the guitar. Click on ukulele. 13th is a Monday. I didn't mean 13. No, Abby arrives on the 13th, but the UK Fest will be that 15th, the Wednesday. On the Wednesday lesson, that'll be the UK Fest with Abby. It'll be a Christmas fest. And then maybe that same evening, we'll do a live stream with my band and Abby as a guest to the band. Okay, so for Jingle Bell Rock, let me see. Let's transpose it down two keys to the key of C. So hit transpose and minus two.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Jingle bell, swing, jingle bell. Snowing and coming, bushes of love. And the jingle bell has begun.
That's really high for me, but maybe you can sing it. So I've switched it to the key of C, and you have the chords for C. When are you putting the Elmer pedal on Etsy? So I was going to put the Elmer pedal on Etsy on Friday, right? Let me share you. It's because in Spanish, compartir is to share. Compartirte is like share to you, but I'm in Spanish mode. Okay. Okay. So James from the Elmer Company had sent me a box of 12 Elmer pedals. I think it's right here. I have them right there on my, right there. And he says, hey, important, we found a software bug in the pedals I sent you. Yes, all 12. I'm going to send you 12 new ones. When you get them, can you return the first 12? And I'll reimburse you for the shipping. So sorry. I'm glad I found the problem before you started selling the pedals. Ah! And I was like, wow, that's huge. And he said, thank you. Just don't post anything on your Etsy store until you get the new pedals. I will put them in the mail tomorrow. And I was like, okay, I'm so sorry you're going through this, but good thing you found out. And he said, we just avoided a disaster. I would have felt terrible if you sold them to your customers and they didn't work. And I was like, imagine. And he said, this is not easy. And I said, people have been asking for the pedals, but I've been really busy and I hadn't been able to post them. And he said, oh my goodness, I'm so glad. And he said, you're the best. And then he said, the UPS tracking for the box of 12 pedals. All working great, but he didn't give me the tracking code. I'm sure that, because he has a lot of other distributors, I'm sure that he sent boxes to other people and they did sell them. And now they're having to like get them back. And that's a big problem. So I'm glad that it, you know, crisis averted. It didn't happen, but they're sending the 12 good ones. But if you want me to reserve one for you, let me know. And, you thought it was my friend now. But let me know if you want me to reserve one for you, and I'll make a list here, and I'll save you one. And I'll post it and, like, send you a message if possible. But Georgiana, are you in our Telegram group? I can share on... Oh, but you're a Patreon member. Actually, yeah. I'll share one. I'll share a few early, and then I'll post it on Patreon. And if you're not a patron, doesn't mean that you have to be on it. But be on our Telegram group. And Peg. Okay, so right now I have Ellie, Madeline, and Peg. Yeah, B, I pulled up the wolf and says sold out. Yeah, they only had 7 left when I made the video. I'm not surprised. It's a really, really nice uke. Again, I don't know, Phyllis, if you'll love the action because it's similar to the one of the Leilani, which it's a little higher up here. Alien, I really enjoyed seeing you live. Great ukulele teacher. Thank you. Okay, so Jingle Bell Rock has quite a few switches. So I would do the syllables as strums. Down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, 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 up. Something like this.
Jingle bell, jingle
Okay, the tricky thing about this song is that I think most of the changes after the first line will be on the up strum. And Georgiana, did you want me to say one for you? Or were you just asking in general? Let me know if you want me to say one for you. So jingle bell, down, up, down. Then switch to C major 7, down, up, down. And then C6 open, jingle bell. So all those have been down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down. But for the word rock, you're going to be switching to a C chord on the up strum. And it's going to be kind of like an incomplete island strum. Up, up, down, up. So it's going to be jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Up, up, down, up. Jingle bells. And then I'm doing down, down, up, down. Down, down, up, down, down, up. On jingle bell swing and D minor jingle bell, and then on the up strum again, up, up, down, up. So let me repeat that from the first line. Down, up, down, down, up, down, up, and down, up, down, see? Up, up, down, up, down, up, down. Down, D minor, down, down, and then G7, up, up, down, up. Next line. Snowing and glowing, bushels of fun. So for snowing and glow and blowing, I do down, snowing, down, down, up, next chord, down, down, up, next chord, down, down, up. And actually on the up, we're back at G7. So it looks like at the end of every line, you're switching on the up strum.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell.
Up, up, down.
Snowing and blowing and pressure of fun. Now the jingle has
begun. Okay. My Georgiana, yes, I wrote you down. So I'm reserving for whatever the price is on the website and then just the price of shipping added to that. So whatever it is on the Elmore website. Lynn. Lynn. Stefan just did the strumming pattern in the chat. Down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. Yeah! That's exactly it. Stefan just wrote it on the chat.
Down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, down.
You can use that on the second line too. On the jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring. Let me try the next line.
Snowing and glowing, a bushel of fun.
You can also do a variation on what Stefan wrote. I'm going to copy what Stefan wrote. You can also do this. So Stefan wrote one of them, and the other one would be this, both of them work. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. And then do that again for the next line.
Down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up.
The second line, you'd pretend that you have two C chords on the second line.
Snowing and glowing.
I keep saying glowing. Lynn, I have you written down for a pedal. So I saved Ellie, Madeline, Georgiana, Peg, and Lynn.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell, swing, jingle bell, swing. Snowing and a blowing, the bushes are fun. Now the jingle bell.
What I love about this site is that you can switch the key to something that works for your voice.
Jingle bell.
Like that feels really high for me. So I'm going to put it in the key of A for myself. Moderators. That is so weird. Okay. What just happened? Thank you. Write me down for that you. So thank you. Wow. Let me transpose it further down to the key of G. Something that's comfortable for your voice. And if you don't know what the singing note is, whatever the name of the first chord is the name of the singing note. And I mean on the word jingle bell. So like right now I switched to the key of G. So that's my first singing note is a G. So I have open G string. Jing, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell. Now if I switched it to something like the key of F, for example, then I would play an F chord, pick on E string, and change the chords. Let's drop some Christmas emojis. Yes, let's drop some Christmas emojis. Use this site. Have fun with it. I'm so glad that they have ukulele on there now. I'm so disappointed in myself for not keeping a secret about the signature uke coming up. You know, and the reason I wanted to do a signature uke with them is because I saw like the level of quality that they could do. Now, if you've been spoiled by me and you're used to getting the gig bag and all the accessories, maybe this is not for you. Because the extra funds have gone in to be elevate the level of ukulele that you're getting, which I think that's better. By the way, I look greasy today. That's not me being actually greasy. You see this? This, what happened here? This situation where it looks greasy. Let me see what I can. Look at that. I think my daughter was playing with the baby shampoo and put it on the brush. And I went to go brush my hair this morning for this live stream. And I just felt like, I was like, what is that? And I smelled it and it was the shampoo. But at that point, it was too late. And I, like, what are you going to do? I just wanted to be live. So that's why I was a little bit late because this situation happened. Love your haircut, by the way. Thank you. I always wanted to have short hair as a kid, but my parents wouldn't let me because, like, long hair was, like, the beautiful thing or whatever. And now, as an adult, I've done it, and I'm so happy. Toddlers, you can't take your eyes off of them. I haven't. That's the thing. I have not been away from her. I don't know when she did it. Let's give some Angela. I think that Angie, I think you gave us the middle finger with your emojis. So funny. So funny because I know you, Angie. I know that you're not like this. By the way, next week, instead of meeting here on YouTube, we will be meeting on Zoom. So I'll share the link to that Zoom on Telegram, and I'll share it on Patreon as a public post. So you don't need to be a Patreon member to see it, because you have, as a, on Patreon, I have the option of making posts public or private. So for next week, we're just going to meet on Zoom, and we're just going to talk about our ukuleles. If you're ready to play part of what we played today, then perform for us. That would be really cool. It could have been honey. Yes, it could have been honey. It could have been glue. So our live streams will be on Zoom every second Monday of the month. I figured the first month Monday would be easy to forget, so decided to make it the second Monday. Toddlers always find a way. I don't know when it happened. Like, I mean, I can't even go to the restroom without taking my eyes off of that girl. So yeah, I feel like there's something about Mary, you know, the scene where Cameron Diaz grabs the hair gel from Ben Stiller and puts it on her hair. But this is what it looks like. It's just stiff. Hilarious. Any news on the straps? I'll put the straps up when I receive the petals. So it'll probably be on Friday, this upcoming Friday. But for any news and updates, always check the Telegram, because that's the best way for me to communicate with you all. I'll also be posting a Patreon newsletter today. Today. And the ukulele events calendar has been updated. So that, hi Karen, where have you been? So all of the events for this month have been posted on the ukulele events calendar. I've removed it, Angie. It was cute to see the emojis with the presents, like so Christmassy, and then the middle finger. Hi Colin. That's so funny. So the ukulele events calendar, the Google one, has the starting date for the chord melody challenge as this Friday as well. And it'll be just 5 days. I figured 5 chord melody songs is attainable for us to learn. So that's kind of what I decided on. And they're going to be short. It's going to be like 2 lines so that you can memorize it or practice and achieve it in a day or two. So that's the goal. Hi, Maria. Long time no see. So this Friday is when we're starting. It's going to be easy melodies, something that you can play either for just your enjoyment or for family. And then my band and I are recording play-alongs to the... Because like 2 years ago, I did a Christmas ukulele challenge with like Silent Night and We Wish You a Merry Christmas and things like that. And it was just the strumming. And so my band and I are recording the actual music videos for that so that you have a play along video. So that's also coming. So lots of videos coming this month. And then for what type, for which one, Madeline? And then for January, I wanted to do a beginner's challenge, kind of. I was thinking about doing like a 5 or 10 day course. And then I decided, you know what? No, I'm just going to do a 1 hour long video that a beginner can watch at their own pace. But everything will be in that one video. So from beginning to something easy, like Stand By Me, you know, that's like 4 chords. What time on Friday? 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time is the time for Friday. He sent the pedals over last Wednesday, so I think he'll have them. You know what? Allie, Georgiana, Lynn, are you a Patreon member, Lynn? What I'll do is I'll post the pedals for Allie, Madeline, Georgiana, Peg, and Lynn as soon as I get them, and then for anyone else who wants the others, because I think I'm getting 12 of them, I'll just post them at 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. What time for the second Monday of each month? Same time as this is. Are you sending out the new calendar? I should post it on Patreon as a news update. Let me see. UKULELE events calendar. Let me share it here. Does anybody happen to have a link to that? Let me see. Oh my goodness. Okay. All right, that person has been reported. I'm pulling up the UKULELE events calendar. Okay. Settings and sharing. Get shareable link. Okay, here it's coming. Alrighty. That's the UKULELE events calendar. The Moody UKULELE player. Hi guys, season's greetings. By the way, can you all, if you want to participate in a giveaway going on right now, Lil Lani is giving away 12 ukuleles for the 12 days of Christmas. Georgiana, who's here, has won one of them. And there's not a lot of people in the competition, so the likelihood of winning one is pretty high. Everyone can report that person. Thank you. So if you go on Instagram and you go to... By the way, a lot of people here have created accounts just for their ukulele playing. So that if you don't want like your friends or family seeing your ukulele journey, you just kind of want it to be something that you do for yourself and that you kind of connect just with other people who are doing what you're doing. That's also that a lot of people have done that. So if you go to the search and type in Leolani, let me see if this will... Leolani underscore Kumu underscore UKULELE. Ooh, Jake Shimabukuro participated. That's so cool.
And on the 10th day of Christmas, Leolani gave to me 10 Humu Humu Nuku Nuku
Applause. So awesome.
Hello, I'm Jake Shimabukuro from Honolulu.
That's so cool. Okay.
On the 11th day of Christmas, Leolani gave to me 11 lunch plates. Hello, everyone. My name is Maya Mayashiro, and it's day 11 of Leolani's 12 Days of Christmas. Today's challenge is a pet's Christmas. Post a pic of you or your ukulele with a furry friend decked out for the holidays. The prize for today's challenge is a Kumu Hawaiian Koa Tenor ukulele. All the details for how to enter are in the comment section below. Good luck, Merry Christmas, and Aloha.
That's amazing. So they're giving away a Kumu. So here are the details. It's a Kumu Hawaiian Koa Tenor Ukulele. So to enter, you must use the hashtag MerryUKMas2021 and tag Leolani. Number two is follow them on Instagram. And number three, post your entry to Instagram or Facebook or send it via email. And then set your account settings to public at least on the day of the challenge, Hawaiian Standard Time. The challenge each day ends at 11:59 p.m. Hawaiian Standard Time. This is so the judges can see it. Have fun, get creative, and give us your best holiday spirit. And so Georgiana, who won this one, oh, and today's challenge, according to, I don't know who this girl is, but I'm going to follow her because she's so cute, Maya. So Maya, okay, I'm following now. Maya said, post a picture of your pet and your ukulele. So I think that if you want to participate, like get super creative, like put bows on both the your pet and your ukulele, like try to do something extra, extra cute. So it's day 11. So today and tomorrow, the last times. And yes, you're a Patreon member. Okay, cool. So oh, look. So here's somebody who entered today. So it's a picture of their pet and the uke. I don't know if you can see it. It looks a little blurry. Sorry. But hold on a second. I think other days it was like gift wrap a ukulele. And so people were like getting really funny with their gift wrapping of ukuleles. I'm sorry, the brightness is kind of off. But it's fun, you know, just participate, just try it. You never know if you might win. And just for fun, why not? One of them was to like make a ukulele cookie. And somebody said that they couldn't make cookies, so they made French fries. Like, how cute is that? I love that. Let me see if I can find the one cookie that made me laugh so hard. I don't see it. And then Georgiana, I don't know if you're still here, but Georgiana participated on the day that I made the challenge, and it was to lip sync to Mariah Christmas, All I Want for Christmas Is You. And Georgiana won with that entry. So you never know. Just try it out. Try it out. I think one of them was like to wear a Christmas sweater. And Yuka Mom wore Christmas sweaters for hers. So have fun with it. Participate. Start up an Instagram account just for your ukulele journey. And just share it and have fun with it. And then if you want to, you can follow me too. And I like to post ukulele humor and lessons. So is there a printable for today? No, I just shared. Oh, no. I just shared links to a website that I like using for some printables. And you can change it to ukulele chords, guitar chords, or piano chords. Today's challenge, according to the Lolani Instagram page, was to share a picture of your ukulele and your pet.
On the 11th day of Christmas, Leolani gave to me 11 lunch plates. Hello, everyone. My name is Maya Maeshiro, and it's day 11 of Leolani's 12 days of Christmas. Today's challenge is a pet's Christmas. Post a pic of you or your ukulele with the furry friend decked out for the holidays. The prize for today's challenge is a Kumu Hawaiian Koa Tenor ukulele.
So a picture of you or your pet? I mean, of your uke or your pet? I would post both of them. Let me see. Recent. Oh, Mati. She's part of our community. She doesn't have a pet, but looks like she got like one of her owls like from her around her house and posted a picture with both of them. Let me see. Somebody put a uke on their goat with a strap on it. Oh, this is a Uglandia member. They're wearing their Uglandia merch and with their puppy by the fireplace. So cute. I'm sorry, these are blurry. It's just, it won't focus. Somebody put reindeer ears on their Doberman, and then you see the ukulele headstock. So have fun. Try it out. Look at how cute that is. And a guitar tab have a Black Friday offer so you can listen and scroll as you play. I think it was about 20 euro for the year. That's cool. I don't have a pet. I guess I'll try to find a deer outside and see if he'll pose with me in my uke. Or the bear. Melinda. Melinda's here. Melinda shared a picture with, looks like a yellow lab and the uke. Yeah, what about Yogi? Exactly. Kaylee's also a member of our community, and Kaylee shared a picture with a Christmas sweater and the puppy. This one's going to be tough. So y'all have to get really creative with your photo. And then the rest of the pictures are from the days before. And they announced the winners like right away. Let's see who won the last one. Guitar Girl Gladys won the last one. So
it's done, and we're going to work on the next one. gonna stay like that overnight. Already enclosed the back of it. It looks pretty good. Wait, patient eyes.
Wow.
And the neck are binding. Close them. Neck is gluing.
She made a whole little ukulele. Wow. Alrighty, there you go. You want to win a uke? Get creative and try. Too bad I didn't get pics of Maggie and the iPad with slipping onto her gun moment. The ornament is beautiful. Alrighty, fam. Well, I'm going to end the live stream here because I want to create an Instagram reel for today. I'm trying to do reels every day, Monday through Friday, on Instagram. So I'm going to go and try to make that. I'm trying to upload like a little tutorial and like a funny one every day. So yes. And then I filmed a tutorial for Careless Whisper, you know, by George Michael. I haven't made the principal, but I want to just release the tutorial ASAP and I'll make the printable later. It's not the same as the guitar tabs because I didn't love their version. So today that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna go make two reels, a funny one, a tutorial one, and then I'm gonna work on the Careless Whisper edit because I filmed it and I sent the audio over to Jonathan. He sent it back to me. So yeah, I'm just gonna work on editing Careless Whisper. I was playing my kazoo with you. Oh, I love that. I wonder if someone who posted a video instead of a picture of their pets would maybe do better in the competition. Like if you were with your birdie, like if you were both quacking at each other with your ukulele. I don't know. I feel like Sayada, I feel like you could win this because you have a bird and your bird is so nosy and so sassy that if you could show that personality, it would be great. Like maybe upload a video and a picture so that you still follow the instructions of a picture. I don't know. I feel like Sayada, you could do it. I think you could do it because you have such a unique pet. Again, the sassiness of your pet would just be like so funny. Alrighty, fam. Now I really will let you go. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today. Oh, thank you for the 98 likes. We almost reached 100. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, Stefan say, let's hit the like button. Thank you so much for everything. I hope that you have a wonderful rest of your day, night, morning, wherever you're at. And woohoo! 100 likes! Take your pants off. So, or put your pants on. Thank you. And go head out to the Instagram and try and participate on those giveaways. If not for anything, just for fun. You know, you never know. Just have fun. Thank you, everyone. Take care, and I will catch you next week for the Zoom or tomorrow for the tutorial. Ciao!